First of all, thank you for spending your lunch for listening to Dacadoo. So basically, what do? We do health scoring. So we score your health in real time. We are completely device agnostic, and we license our health score to large payers and providers globally in the healthcare sector. One of our large clients is Optum. Optum is owned by United Healthcare Group, which is the world's leading healthcare operator. We serve three different markets: life and health insurance operators, employers, and very large brands. Why is Dacadoo unique? Because we spent 8 years and over $50 million only in developing our health score, which is completely electronic medical record, device, and lifestyle data independent. We don't sell any data to anyone. You own your data. We've been fully GDPR compliant and HIPAA compliant since 2 years. We use artificial lifestyle navigation, so we have programmed over 4,000 healthy rules into your lifestyle navigator. So just like you have a car navigation system. Last but not least, we are very agile, so we develop 4 different systems for our clients around the world. I'm what you call a serial entrepreneur. I've built 3 companies that went public, and my last company I sold to Thomson Reuters. And that is, of course, no guarantee for future performance. But I went after the healthcare market and the AI market, as we're going to see a very strong growth coming over the next years. So the digital healthcare market will obviously be AI-based, and it will be very strongly driven, at least from our point of view, rule-based, voice-based, and with very smart, object-oriented technologies. So if we go just one step back, we all knew the mainframe, the client-server computing, then came C, C++, Java, and now we moved into the whole artificial intelligence space, as we heard from Professor Smith Hooper this morning. So we started with neural networks, we then went into deep learning, and now we believe that we will have what we call near-human AI. So basically, our whole rules engine, look at how you sleep, how you eat, how you feel, etc. So at the end of the day, it doesn't matter if you take capital markets, medicine, etc. AI, in many cases, will beat human beings' intelligence. So if you look at today in the capital markets, around 95% of all asset managers will never beat their, you know, index that they are supposed to beat over a period of 10 years. I personally believe, and I have many good friends who are doctors, that in the future, you will actually have robots doing heart surgery, et cetera. And if you have less money, I know it sounds weird, you might take a human doctor because there's higher risk going forward. So basically, AI will become a very important part of medicine, insurance industry, and digital health. So what have we built? We've built a health score, we've built an AI platform, and we built a point system. So we start with Dacadoo Go. So it's a walking app where we use gamification. We then have the whole health score platform, which we have licensed to many large healthcare operators. We have so far scored over 300 million man years of clinical data. So we most likely run the largest data set in digital health today. We are now starting to work on what we call pay as you live. We have filed over 90 patents, 90, over 25 patents are already granted. So pay as you live is, of course, like pay as you drive. So in the future, life insurance or health insurance will give a premium based on your lifestyle. Last but not least, we have developed a risk engine that we're just coming out with. This risk engine uses imputation. So we score backwards. We take the 300 million man years of clinical data and integrate this together with the underwriter's risk engines. With Dacadoo Go, we are the first company in the world that are mixing offline to online. What do I mean by that? So basically, we create a walking game, and it's not a cheap version of Pokemon Go, where you can physically integrate it with the retail industry. The biggest problem in retail today is, of course, the combination between offline and online. And we are combining that with augmented reality. So we can do picture recognition in the shop. We can drive people into the shop. We can drive people into the doctor, the fitness clubs, etc. Why did I found Dacadoo after I sold my previous company to Thomson Reuters? Because I have 5 kids, and I was seriously concerned about NCDs and most of my life privately, I spend a lot of time trying to make a difference. So basically, when a health insurance or life insurance company start the beginning of the year, they've already spent 68% of their budget on NCDs. So basically, chronic diseases. What does that mean? In the world now, we have 1.1 billion people that have hypertension, meaning high blood pressure. We have over 300 million people that are right now being treated for depression. We have over 600 million people, and increasing very rapidly, that have obesity. You now, in this country, it doesn't matter if you're in England or Switzerland, where I'm from, or in America, you have children that are 10 years old that are obese. Normally, as you know, diabetes 2 was called old man, disease, and now you have kids that are 10 years old that have diabetes. So basically, we are creating a lot of data. I started programming in a very young age, and the biggest concern I have is we will create a monster amount of data in digital health. But if we don't make a meaning to it, it will not make sense to anyone. So what we have patented is the health score. It's a number from 1 to 1,000. It's a proxy of your life in real time, completely hardware agnostic. It integrates the Fitbit, the iPhones, the Apple Watch, etc. We then add a rule-based system that we call the feedback loop. The feedback loop uses artificial intelligence. It has over 4,000 rules of stock content. It speaks 13 different languages. And then on top of that, you have our content editor, where you can, of course, add your own content. I spoke at the McKinsey's Life Leader Forum in Chicago, which is the leading life insurance conference, and presented the following concept. Number one, I believe the future of life and health insurance, which is, by the way, the world's largest industry, $8 trillion in revenue, it will become pay-as-you-live oriented. That will still be the solidarity principle, but it would be a lot more market-driven. Number two, the something-for-something economy, meaning that you will have point systems, just like you load in retail or an airline industry. And number three, it will go on to the blockchain. So according to the McKinsey guy who spoke before me at the Global Life Leaders Forum, you can take out about 25% of the cost budget from life insurance operators. Health insurance operators, they will become service-based organizations. What you see on your left is a patch that measures your heartbeat. It can take your insulin, everything. What you see on your right is an automated medicine injection that sits next to your kidney or liver, wherever the medicine is supposed to be injected. Meaning in the future, the insurance company, as just being the payer of your bills, will be over. So what have we done? We've created a health score. We scored over 300 million man years of clinical data before we went out on the street. We didn't raise any venture capital money. It was four families and Samsung and Rakuten from Japan that all went together and said, over 10 years, we're going to build a global health standard. I believe we are there now. We have over 200 million potential lives under contract in 14 different countries. By year end, it would be 20 different countries. So basically, we take those 300 million man years of clinical data. We have all public health studies integrated. We add all of the outcome, and then we start scoring that data and create the health score. On top of that, we integrate the risk engine so we can calculate your risk of getting a heart attack, your risk of getting diabetes 2, et cetera. Last but not least, it's not something people talk a lot about. I believe the future of healthcare would be very voice driven. So we already integrated Alexa and Siri and stuff like this. So you can basically at home know about your health, know about your sleeping quality, so the device will talk to you about your health. So to kind of wrap up in this presentation today, and thank you so much for listening, number one, I believe we never understood healthcare really deep. And I believe with the health score, we have a number that everybody understands. Everybody understands their age. Everybody understands their weight. But nobody ever tried to describe health for our over 8 billion people living on the planet. Number two, I believe you will track your health in the future, and you will not run around with some Fitbit or a big chain around your neck. They would be nano patches that would automatically measure your blood pressure, your acidity on the skin, your heart rate, your turning rate, your fall detection, etc. Number three, insurance companies today have zero integration with their clients. So myself, I have two life insurance and a health insurance. I never met anyone from my insurance company. So it's sold through a broker. It's a completely impersonal relationship. Number four is, as we start to understand health better and better, we will start making rule-based systems. And last but not least, it would be a connected world where you will have your own context, your own content editor. So an example of, of digital health in the future would be something like this. So this is an example of a fully object-oriented.
Alexa, start the timer for 2 minutes.
2 minutes, starting now.
Alexa, how long does it take to fly from Zurich, Switzerland to Hong Kong?
The flight time between Zurich and Hong Kong is approximately 12 hours.
This is to show it's real
Alexa,
time.
Alexa, cancel timer.
2 minutes, timer canceled.
Alexa, ask Dacadoo about my step count.
You have taken 8,800 steps today. That is below your average of 10,400. But the day still has some hours left.
Alexa, please ask Dacadoo about my workouts in the past 10 days.
You have logged 7 workouts over the past 10 days with a total duration of 16 hours and an energy transfer of 10,500 kilocalories. You spent most time with mountain biking.
Alexa, ask Dacadoo about my health score.
Your Dacadoo health score is 682. That is down 41 points as of 30 days ago. Feeling is the biggest contributor to this change.
So basically what it shows you is that we will see a completely new way of assisted living. We will have 30% of all people in society that would be over 65 years of age within the next 10 years in the Western world. So basically, we cannot keep on putting those people in hospital. We will have over 1 billion people that would be obese, and we will have over 600 million people that would have diabetes. And that's why we created Dacadoo. We want people to understand their health. We want them to navigate their health. And for something economy, that people that look after themselves get a better premium for their insurance. Thank you so much for listening.